as I said, that inside of this IPsec tunnel, there can be different VPN segments that can be like talked as, or that can be considered as the service VPNs. So there are three types of VPNs that are going to be out there in your SD-WAN fabric. One, it's going to be transport VPN, which is going to be VPN number 0. Second is going to be service VPN. It's going to be any VPN between 1 to VPN 511. And third, it's going to be out-of-band management VPN. It is going to be VPN number 512. These are the number of VPNs that you can actually have. And network segmentation works for such kind of VPNs there. So it's like in your internal fabric, when you have a WAN is there, and this WAN is, let's say, has three prefixes, let's say 10.0.0.0, 20.0.0.0, and 30.0.0.0. This 10 can be part of VPN 1. This 20 can be part of, let's say, VPN number 2. And 30 can be part of VPN number 3. So all these VPN data will be segregated from each other when it actually sends or communicates within the IPsec tunnel there. So it's like VPN 1 on this side will only be able to communicate with VPN 1 on this side. VPN 2 will only be able to communicate with VPN 2 and VPN 3 with VPN 3. That's how basically segmentation is achieved over here. So networks also face scalability challenges. When network requirements call for supporting segmentation or different topologies per network segment, in such scenarios, like MPLS layer 3 VPN or MPLS over DM VPN, it can be complex here. But by default, then your SD-WAN fabric supports segmentation in this way, that you can configure multiple VPNs there according to that.